At the Bell Museum, our mission is served by teaching and research. Research is roughly broken down into field work, where we're out in nature capturing birds and sampling them, and lab work, where we're taking those samples and using cutting-edge techniques to understand things about those organisms. Last spring, we took our students to Itasca State Park to gather samples and to train those students in field methods. Part of our mission is to make sure that that doesn't stop, that we're training our students to be able to do that going into the future.
Getting to actually get outside and connect with that natural world that I'm studying in person is wonderful. Getting to hold a live bird and feel its little fluttering heart and see its beautiful feathers in person is never going to stop being amazing.
One of the hard things about museum science is sometimes we are collecting things. We actually have to kill them to study them. And that's a hard thing. It's something we don't enjoy, but it's something that we do in order to understand the thing that we love. A lot of the frontier now is taking what we already have in collections and understanding the diversity in a more nuanced way.
I've been beginning to learn how to CT scan. With a typical museum skin, what we have is the exterior of the bird. So we have the color, the feathers, how they look at that moment in time when they died. Interior tissue, you don't have that for as long because they rot. But with the CT scan, we have this sort of lasting image of what those interior parts of the bird look like in a way that's similar to a museum skin.
I'm using spatial analysis tools to help me process species ranges, look for overlaps, doing calculations on correlations with environmental variables, by which I mean rainfall or land cover and all those things.
I've always been fascinated with molecular data, so sequences of DNA. Right now, you can pretty easily sequence the whole genome of an organism, either from a tissue sample that we've frozen in the field, or even from a round skin that's been in the drawer for, 100, 200 years.
I just got DNA out of a specimen from 1915 the other day. 1915, that was like 50 years before we even knew what the structure of DNA was. And I just got DNA out of this specimen. It's amazing.
It's amazing how in this sort of environment, even though we have a shared idea about what kind of science we're interested in, there's still so much variation. There's such a great diversity of ideas.
More complex answers are always more exciting because life is complex. The Earth is complex.
We can gather data from the world around us as it is now and infer things about what happened thousands or even millions of years ago in the past.